Hello, everyone. Welcome again to Trump's Ask the Expert. I'm Dave Dobson, and today we're going to talk about offset bending or Z bending on your TRUMPF press rake. The first thing you want to do is, of course, enter your material thickness, the tools you're using, as well as the back gauge positions you need. The lower dead point will be calculated automatically, and you can begin the process. Okay, when getting your Z bend tool set, you should probably start with the tooling offset just so you can make sure you're not going to have any collision. So I start with my tools offset from each other and run the ram down. Once I see that there's not going to be a collision, I can then slide my bottom tool back into position and run the ram down one more time. What you're looking for is the tools to be completely touching. Right here I have a gap, so I know that my Z-bend is not going to be 290s. This is a way to do air bending. If you're looking for 245 degrees or open bends, you can use 90 degree Z-bend tools to accomplish this by simply not running the Y-axis down as far. Again, when I go to bend this, you'll see I'm not hitting hard enough. So the two things I need to adjust, first off, is the lower dead point. I adjust my lower dead point down the needed distance and run the ram down again. You can see now my tools are touching and there's no gap, no light coming through. I can now re-hit my bend. And I achieve my 290s. Now, if my bends are still open, the next thing I want to adjust is the press force. If I have a lower dead point that's set correctly, but not enough press force to get there, I'll have two open bends. So the next thing I would adjust would be my press force to make sure I'm hitting the material hard enough. So I back off on my press force so you can see. Now I'm going to hit it again. And another 90 and 90 degree Z-bend or offset tool. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.